in the late 60s, there was a wellspring on college campuses across the country regarding the absence of African-American or African peoples within the curriculum.
In the years moving up to 1969, there was a progression of our coming together and our concerns about the environment we found ourselves in. And we talked about the things that we felt we needed. We needed to have more of us. I came in a class that had only 12 students, 12 African-American students. And we wanted to be able to have a larger number of students. We wanted to be taught about ourselves and our own heritage. We felt that that had scholastic weight to it and should be taught in the academy. We wanted there to be tenure-track faculty who also looked like ourselves. We wanted to live together, so we didn't have to explain why our hair texture was as it is or why we liked certain kinds of food and so on. We wanted to be able to cook our own food, actually. So we wanted a dormitory, our own dormitory.
Here at Vassar in particular, we have the distinction of having a significant demonstration taken on by the students at Vassar.
In the fall of 1969, I was president of SAS, the Students African American Society. And as students, we had meetings to determine what it would be that we could do to get the college's attention. It was decided unanimously that we would take over the main administration building.
Over 30 women were involved in the takeover of main building, which is the key administrative building of the college. And as opposed to some of the other demonstrations across the country, this demonstration was particularly female-led.
We weren't doing any of this in isolation. There were other students on other campuses who were feeling the same way. And I think we felt a kinship and resonated with the same kinds of issues. And we felt that if there were ever going to be a time to do it, it was that was the time. So we did.
4 days after occupying the building, the trustees, who had been called for a special emergency meeting, came to the conclusion that the 9 demands that the African American students had requested were valid, and decided that we as students should be given those demands and allowed amnesty with no repercussions from the college. This is the decision of the trustee board that carried through to Vassar, and we now have an Africana Studies program at Vassar College 50 years after this incident.
This is our 50th year of existence at Vassar College. We're very pleased and very happy that through a lot of hard work by a number of professors and a number of administrators that Africana Studies is still going strong. And we thought that it was important to mark the commitment of Vassar to this field of study. We brought together scholars from all over the country to celebrate this. And so it was a 3-day event. It started with bringing back to campus the past directors of the program. We were very fortunate to host the newly minted MacArthur Genius Fellow Award winner, Sadia Hartman. She presented on her brand new book. It's called Wayward Subjects, and it's a book about African-American women at the turn of the century. Sadia was able to sit down with three members of our Vassar community. We called it 3 generations of Vassar women engaging Sadia Hartman. There was a student, Karina Norton, a junior professor, Yasmin Sayadullah, and a senior professor, Diane Hereford. We had the pleasure of witnessing Shona Tucker's performance. She's written a wonderful play. It's biographically inspired. It's called Growing Wild. Professor Tucker, who is the chair of the drama department here, is fresh off a run with the Broadway play To Kill a Mockingbird. And so we were very, very fortunate to steal her away from the Broadway production for her to perform her one-woman show. And then on Saturday, we had a series of three panels where we had nine guests ranging from Harvard University to Georgia Tech University in the South. Our nine guests, the three of our panels was, the names were, the first panel was named What the Dark Past Has Taught Us. The second panel was named When They See Us with a question mark. And the third panel was named The Futures of Freedom. We were extremely fortunate to have the Matthew Vassar Lecture by the award-winning novelist Aminata Forna. We also wanted to celebrate the inimitable Milfred Fierce, who was the first director of Africana Studies. And he was particularly important because Professor Fierce mentored and guided these students well beyond what was expected in the classroom. Particularly, we wanted to acknowledge the vibrant work of Larry Mamiya. Larry Mamiya was the founder of our prison studies program. And it is very clear that when you look at Larry's life in retrospect, it was very clear that he was quite literally saving lives. Vassar College prides itself on women who are going to go, when necessary, go past convention, go past the rules in play in order to do what's right. We wanted to acknowledge what these women had done, because if they hadn't taken over main building when they did in 1969, there wouldn't be a program.